previously on the Insiders.
The strangest dream last night. I know I can still do it. I can still write. I can still report. But I'm just not sure I want to anymore. Tom, get this. Remember that dream I had about Pete?
Where he quit the Press-Gazette and ended up writing for the State Journal?
Yeah, well, I had another one. It's like a month later, and Pete's still angry and bitter about the whole thing.
Dreadlocks this time, huh?
I like to mix it up. Anyway, Pete wants to get back at us, so he starts spilling all of our secrets to Jason Wilde.
You know, just bump him or say something to throw him off. He'll, you know, he's going to be out there. He's not going to be thinking straight. The thing with Rob is, he's just not very bright. So if you get a chance, ask him to do some math. And Tom, during group interviews, he likes to be on the left side. So if you can block him from getting over there, oh, if you get a chance, he cannot use felt-tip pens. Oh, in press conferences, Rob hates to be interrupted. Oh, and, you know, he's not very tall. If you get a chance to walk past him, stand up on your toes a little bit and look at him and ask him if he's shrinking. Oh, and if you want to get in Vandermouse's head, you know, he's a terrible game picker, so ask him who he thinks is going to win. He'll just start babbling for an hour. He won't even go talk to any players or any coaches or anything. He won't get any work done.
Pete, this is all great and all, but you've been working here only a month. Don't you think you should probably focus on figuring out how to do your job with us?
Nah, I'd rather get even.
It's so weird you keep having these unique and original dreams that in no way reflect current events.
I know, I wish this one would just end already.
Well, I think we both know there's no hope of that. What's up, everybody? Welcome back to the Insiders. I'm Tom Pellicero. He's Rob Demovsky. Rob, you just got done listening to 15 minutes of Brett Favre speaking in New York regarding the allegations that came out, or not even really allegations, but the information that came out via Fox Sports report last Sunday. It was painted in by some media sources as a denial, but really he confirmed a lot of the key facts. So at this point, it seems like what was the intent? That's now the issue, and what is your take on that?
You know, it seems to me that, and I believe Favre when he says that Matt Millen initiated the conversation. He said they talked a little bit about coming down to Matt Millen's land and hunting, and then he started asking them, well, how'd you guys do this against us when you beat us last year? What kind of things did you do to attack us? And Favre claims he didn't give him much useful information. That, you know, I'm not sure of. The problem I had with what Favre said today was he tried to use the defense, well, this happens all the time. There are guys on our team, meaning the Jets, that used to play for Arizona, and before we played Arizona, we asked those guys, you know, what information they could give us that would help. Well, that's different. Those guys are now on your team. You're telling another team how to beat your old team. I think that's where Brett is convinced that he didn't do anything wrong, and in that case, I disagree with him.
The team on the field that the Packers does have now, coming off easily their biggest win of the season, absolutely dominating the Indianapolis Colts last week. That was a game that I know the team viewed as something that could really turn their season, because the difference between going into the bye 4-3 or 3-4 off a home win or a home loss. The Colts go on and play the Tennessee Titans, the Packers' next opponent, this Monday night. How big is that game in terms of you determining whether the Packers beat a pretty good team or not?
I'll be real curious to watch that Monday night game, see what happens. And then you have to factor in that the Packers are coming off the bye, have the extra week, and Tennessee's going to be coming in off a short week. I think that all factors into it. Now, if Tennessee goes out there and dominates the Colts, then I'm pretty sure the Packers have a tough game in front of them no matter whether it's a long layoff or not.
For Rob, I'm Tom. You don't feel good about this performance today? I think you did fine. We'll see you next week.
Hey, boys.
Hey.
So, Rob, I hear that rash you had finally cleared up.
How'd you hear about that?
I have my sources.